Hello, my name is Jeff McCune and I'm a developer at Puppet Labs. In this video, I'd like to show how easy it is to get started with Puppet Enterprise 2.5 on Windows. So what you see here is a standard Windows 7 virtual machine, and I've downloaded the Puppet Enterprise installer onto my desktop. So to get started, all we need to do is double click on the installer and run through the installation wizard. So, to install Puppet Enterprise, the only two required options that we have are the installation directory to install Puppet into, and the host name of the Puppet Master that this agent will connect to. So in this demo, I'd like to use puppetmaster.vm. These questions can also be fully automated using MSI exec on the command line. In Windows 7 and Windows 2008, the MSI is integrated with the user account control feature of Microsoft Windows. We need administrator privileges to actually install Puppet Enterprise and configure the Windows service. So that's what you see here. It's a good idea to check that the verified publisher is actually Puppet Labs. So while Puppet is installing, this process will copy all of the files onto the system drive and configure the Windows service to run and Puppet agent to check in with the Puppet Master periodically, every 30 minutes by default. I should also note that it's not required that you install Puppet onto the Windows system drive, but you can install it onto any drive that you'd like. So that's all it takes to install Puppet Enterprise on Windows. At this point, the service is running in the background and Puppet agent is already checking in with the Puppet Master. As you can see here in the start menu, we have Puppet Enterprise showing up, and we've got some nice shortcuts and documentation links. Puppet Enterprise also includes a utility called Factor, which is useful to gather information about the machine the Puppet is managing. Similar to installation, Factor and Puppet require administrative permissions to access some of the resources that it needs to configure a Windows machine. So on Windows 7 and Windows 2008, that's what the user account control dialog is showing. So when Factor runs, it will collect information about the machine, such as the serial number, the number of CPUs in the machine, the type of CPU, other useful information like the operating system and release version, the IP address, the MAC address, the amount of memory, things like this. All of this information will also be centrally available in the Puppet Enterprise console. So if you have a large number of Windows machines and you find it difficult to keep track of what resources you have in what machine, all of that is available here in the Puppet Enterprise console. So I'm going to log in with Internet Explorer. And we can see that the Windows machine is already checking in to the Puppet Master. So if we click on it here, we can see that all of those facts that I just showed you in the command prompt are also centrally available. In addition, the installer will create a standard Windows service, which I'd like to show you now. So I'm going to bring up the services console. And here you can see all of the default services that are part of a Windows machine. But we also have the Puppet agent now. So if you'd like to disable Puppet agent on a particular node, it's just a matter of stopping the service. And if you'd like to start it back up again, we can just start it easily. When the service starts, Puppet agent will check in with the Puppet Master and we'll get a new report. So thank you for your time. What you saw in this video is the installation of Puppet Enterprise on a Windows machine using our standard MSI package. Puppet Enterprise collecting inventory information using Factor and centrally reporting that into the Puppet Enterprise console, and the Puppet agent running as a standard Windows service in Windows 7. Thank you for your time, and I hope you enjoy Puppet Enterprise on Windows.